Welcome once again to Lehto's Law. Here's Steve Lehto.
I'm not a big gambler. I've mentioned that before. Once in a while, I'll bet straight up on a football game, lunch, you know, whoever wins this game, that kind of thing. But generally speaking, not really. Don't buy tons of lotto tickets or something like that. But once, I'd say once a year, maybe once every couple of years, when one of those mega super jackpot thingies, lottos, multi-states, hits like $150 or $250 million, occasionally I buy a ticket. You pay a couple bucks for just the feeling that theoretically, you could win. It's highly unlikely, but you could. So you pay a couple bucks just the excitement of thinking, yeah, I could win. But that's it. Well, interesting story that Daryl sent me out of North Carolina. A North Carolina man accidentally bought two identical lottery tickets, and they both won. Now, when I saw that headline, my first thought was, oh, poor guy. Because there are some jackpots that go to whoever's holding a winning ticket. And so if you are the only person holding both winning tickets, it wouldn't have helped you any. But it turns out that this is in a lottery where you do get more. So he's going to win twice as much for having done this. But it's a funny story. Teresa Waldrop wrote it for CNN, WRAL, reported it, as did others, out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. A man there wasn't sure if he'd bought a ticket in the state's Lucky for Life lottery drawing. So he filled out an online form and bought a ticket. Unbeknownst to him, he'd already bought a ticket, and apparently it slipped his mind, and apparently he had some lucky numbers that he liked to play because he played the exact same numbers both times. He said, I was just laying in bed watching a basketball game on TV, and I couldn't remember if I filled out my form or not. And the man's 49 years old from Fayetteville, and here he is giving a quote to the North Carolina Education Lottery. And a lot of states have lotteries where the money is earmarked for education. So it's another reason you gamble. You're doing it for a good cause. He said, I went ahead and filled it out again. And the next morning, my son asked why there were two different amounts listed. I realized, I think I filled it out twice. It turned out he had won $25,000 a year for life twice. And that was once for each ticket in the drawing that happened on November 27th. That prize is the Lucky for Life's drawing second biggest prize behind $1,000 a day for life payout, according to the lottery. So I guess he didn't win the big one, but $25,000 a year for life ain't a bad deal. When I realized I won, I had to lay down on the floor because I really just couldn't believe it, he said. It's just a blessing. He is a dump truck operator. He opted for a lump sum of $780,000 for both tickets instead of annual payments, according to the lottery, saying he wanted to invest his money in his business, pay off some bills, help his family, and perhaps buy a house. After taxes, he netted $551,000, $851,851 to be exact. So again, you often have that option where if you want to, you can take payments for life, for 20 years or whatever it is, or they'll give you a lump sum right now. I don't think I've ever heard of anyone ever taking the payments. They always take the lump sum. And I know that people will tell you, Steve, all these accountants, CPAs, and investment advisors will always tell you, take the money in a lump sum because if you invest it well, you can do better than the payments they're going to pay you. There's the problem. Most people don't know how to invest it well. And there are some great documentaries out there about how the lottery affected people's lives. In fact, I've seen one that was entitled something to the effect of, "The Lottery Ruined My Life." And they went and found a bunch of people who had hit the lottery, big prizes, and bad things had then happened due to decisions they had made. And quite often, when you hit the lottery on a big one, and I suspect that this right here, $780,000, is enough money to get the attention. But what happens is if you hit the lottery and people find out it was you, suddenly all of your friends remember they were supposed to call you. All of your pseudo friends think they're your friends. Long lost relatives just now figured out where you are. Oh, I've been looking for you the whole time. I saw you on TV. Of course, that's how I found out you're still living in the same home you've been in for 20 years. And so everyone comes out of the woodwork looking for money. And I've heard these crazy stories where somebody says, you know, I bought this person a house, I bought that person a house. And some people, when they get a big chunk of money, I'm talking about hundreds of millions of dollars, actually think There's no way I could blow through this. I can just spend this as fast as I want because I can't spend it all. They think that that's possible. And many of them surprise themselves with the fact that they do wind up actually spending it all. And one of my favorite stories was there was one of the first big jackpots. I'm talking like 20 years ago now, but I've seen several documentaries about the same person. And one guy hit the big jackpot. It was the big jackpot. I believe it was hundreds of millions of dollars. And of course, he takes the lump sum. And he then proceeds to do a bunch of crazy stuff, including at one point in time, he bought himself a jet. I believe it was a 737, but a very, very large Boeing jet. Not a small business jet, big commercial jet. He doesn't have a pilot's license, so he hires a pilot. And at one point in time, he bought a house in a gated community in Florida. And it had a garage, so he filled it with cars. He bought a bunch of Lamborghinis, one of each color. And at one point in time, he took a journalist from a local TV station through his house and was showing her everything that he'd bought with his money. And at one point, he walks into a room that looks kind of like the entryway to the Detroit Institute of Arts, where they've got suits of armor on display. And the guy had all these suits of armor in this one room, and he goes, "I've always wanted to have a collection of armor." And at that point, you realize, okay, this guy will burn through the money pretty quickly. And he did, by the way. He wound up completely broke. House got foreclosed upon, sold at a tax auction. And at one point in time, though, and this may have been the low point, at one point in time, I believe it was him, but someone called 911 from that house and said, "My girlfriend just stabbed me with my crack pipe." Now, that's a sentence that when you find yourself saying that to a 911 operator, you've made bad choices in your life. "My girlfriend just stabbed me with my crack pipe." There are about 8 or 9 things wrong with that statement. I mean, it's actually a grammatically correct statement. I'm talking about the facts of your life that have led you to the point where you are calling 911 on your girlfriend because she stabbed you with your crack pipe. So, broke. A lot of these people wind up broke. And the irony of it is that many of them went into the lottery not broke, meaning that if you graft their income, they go along like this, and they're actually in the black. They might not be rich, but they're in the black. They win the lottery, and they're suddenly way up here, and then when they crash below the line they were at when they were just cruising along before the lottery. And a lot of people, unfortunately, it happens to. And I've heard some crazy stories about people, about how much money they had, what they blew the money on, and then what happened to them. And sadly, a bunch of people have actually been demised because of the money they came into for a variety of other reasons. And so it'll actually shorten your life expectancy sometimes to win one of those big lotteries. I'm not saying it's not a reason to, you know, I'm not saying it's a reason to avoid playing, you know, but the first thing I would suggest to anybody who comes into a big pile of money would be, suppose you got $100 million, $100 million, okay? That's the lump sum you get. The first thing you do is you take $5 million of it, because you ain't going to miss it, right? Take $5 million of it and stick it in an irrevocable trust that you can't touch for 10 years, 15 years. Pick a length of time that you can't touch it. Put it there and leave it there. And, you know, invest it in stocks or something. But, you know, but put it there and leave it there. You might say, "But Steve, $5 million, you still got 95 left." That's the whole point. I dare you now to blow that 95, because you will. And when you come up broke at the other end, you go, "Boy, I'm glad I put that $5 million aside. Now I just got to wait 12 years till I can get it." But the point is that you won't miss it at the front end, so park it to where you can get into it at you know, somewhere else down the road. The other thing I would strongly urge you to do if you ever hit a lottery like that would be to consult with a financial consultant, but somebody who's good. Don't go to this is a friend of a friend of mine. My next door neighbor's cousin does this. No. Go to somebody reputable and say, "What can I do to put the bulk of this money aside to where it'll earn me money? I'll still have some money to play with, but I won't be tempted to buy the jet and hire the pilot and then buy Lamborghinis, one in each color," because that's what the guy did down in Florida there. So yeah, there's a lot of ways to burn through the money, and people do burn through it faster than they think. But I'm hopeful for this guy. Love the story. He bought 2 tickets that are identical and wound up winning identical prizes, which grand totaled out to $780,000 before taxes and $551,000 after. It's not a bad chunk of change there from WRAL out of Raleigh, North Carolina. North Carolina man accidentally bought two identical lottery tickets and won two jackpots. Daryl, thanks for sending it. Questions or comments, put them below. Let's talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching Lehto's Law. Can you draw how it feels to be happy? Yes, you may use stick people in your drawing.